Hey guys, Mike here, one go short play. Playing Cycles for the Amiga 500. I guess it would have been 500, it's like 1989. Wow, some things never change. Ooh, like it. That is quite pretty. Nice bit of pixel art. That's it. Oh, there's a nice little effect coming up, but I hit the fire button, so we'll never know. But I'm liking the look of this, this looks good. Yeah, we'll go for some of these. Let's just see what it's about. Is he pushing that bike? That was quite cute. Okay. As you might have noticed, I've started putting voiceovers on my videos just to make them a bit more interesting for you. And it actually makes it a bit more fun for me too, because I'm normally screaming at the computer anyway or making some kind of frustrated noises at the game. Japan? Yeah, fair enough. Which you guys aren't really party to, so I thought I had a microphone lying about the place. I thought I'd stick it on. Here it is. And see how, if you guys like me talking over these things. Oh, this is cool. What's that Mega Drive game, Kawasaki Racing? Oh, nothing's happening. Oh, hello. How do I do that? Ah, you push up. This is a bit Kawasaki Racing. And if anyone's played that on the Mega Drive, you'll know what I mean. Except on that, the screen kind of rotates like the bike is doing here. This is alright though. Is it? I'm guessing it's vector based. It looks kind of vector based. Fire button. The fire button, it does nothing. The. I am pushing up on the joystick to go forward. And that's pretty cool. It's pretty responsive. It jumps back a little bit after a turn, like that. But it kind of works. It gives you that weird, it does give you that impression of being on a bike, that kind of bobbing feeling. You get a little bit of that from it. I would definitely, if you like the look of this, I would definitely recommend Kawasaki Racing for the Sega Mega Drive. I actually bought a hard copy of that, having played it on an emulator and thinking it absolutely brilliant. Now, I'm not a motorbike nut or anything. I've never owned a motorbike in my life, but I did ride a scooter for about 5 years and yeah, nearly killed myself a few times on it. I have fallen off that scooter a few times too. Sometimes on icy conditions and sometimes just because I was driving like an arse. But that's as close as I've ever got to riding a motorbike, except for this, or you know, much more impressive modern motorbike games. But this is really cool. I'm actually really impressed with this. Why wasn't this better known than it is? That's what's on my mind. This is great. Although, I mean, alright. That might be over egging the pudding, but let's have a look at this. Oh, got some nice roady bumps going on. What we're really missing here, and I'm sure you're noticing, is any kind of opposition. Now, what does cross my mind about that is the controls are, when it comes to cornering and that sort of thing, alright, I'm pushing up on the joystick. That could be a fire button thing, that would make it much cooler. Ooh, finish. But I imagine sticking bikes into this, from a playability point of view, would make it a little bit awkward to play. A little bit, you know, maybe too difficult to dodge around with that narrow little road. That said, I'm about to be proved totally wrong, but we'll find out, eh? I was going to say maybe it's a technical thing if we're using vectors here. Maybe, you know, there's limits. I know nothing about the limits of the Amiga, really. I would have thought you could put more bikes on the screen. And apparently you can. So I'm going to shut up. Because I've just been proved totally wrong. This game is not missing opposition. There are at least, what, five bikes on the screen at once there. And, yeah, playability is not affected by it at all. It's really cool. It is one of those games that makes you play or talk, but let's see how I do. I do wish I could select the fire button to, you know, accelerate. I think that would, because I can't really get to the turning. Actually, if you use the D-pad, maybe that's a bit easier, because I'm using an Xbox 360 pad, so I've been using the analog stick. What I'm finding now I'm using the D-pad, and it's marginally easier. Or is it? It's marginally easier, yeah. Because you're dealing with kind of booleans on off for the switches for the left, right, up and down. Whereas on the analog pad, you're kind of pushing it further than you necessarily need to. Ah, that was stupid. Oh, come on. Get on the track. That's frustrating. But no, this is a good game. This is cool. I like this. I actually rather like it. Now, let's try and win. Where are we? We're fifth gear. We're doing 116 miles per hour. Our position is that sixth? Laps one to go. Yeah, we might not win this race. Let's see if we can get up fifth. Is that right? Have I just gone to fifth? I don't know. I was so busy looking at the top right corner that I didn't even notice if I overtook someone. Now, and that's obviously some time thing going on there. Now, let's see if I can overtake that guy. That is my aim for this race. There is a dude behind me bumping away at the back of me, so to speak. But I am ignoring him. I'm going for the dude in front. I'm going to beat him and come fourth. That is my plan. Oh, I like that. You do get that proper leaning into corners thing. My plan is not going to come to fruition, is it? Oh, another lap. Let's go. We can do this. Foul. Yeah, let's go for first. Fourth place, yes. Oh, I'm hitting the bike in front. Third place. Yeah, that's not an issue, that whole space on the track thing for the bikes. The game really accommodates all that. We're in second place. Hey, we're doing all right here. I'm going for it. Just can't come off the track. Come on, Mike. Come on, you can do this. You can do this. Yes, you can. There he is. See him up ahead. I've got my eye on you, sunshine. Ah! Don't fall off the track. Come on, lad. Come on. I was about to say, is there some sort of top-down map that tells you where they are? But yes, there is. I can see it now. He looks miles ahead on that map. I might be coming second in this race. I think I'd be happy with that, though, for a first go. Second place seems pretty, pretty reasonable for a first attempt. That's got to put you through to the next level as well, hasn't it? Oh, it's nice, this. Tell you what, though, for a game such a simple, understated name, I did that before, as Cycles, this is an awesome motorbike game. Awesome motorbike game. If you fancy firing up the Amiga and you've never played this, I would definitely recommend it. It's got definitely something of Kawasaki Superbikes. Is that what it was called? Kawasaki Superbikes? I can't remember. On the Mega Drive. That's worth checking out too. It's definitely got something of that. In fact, that game has a kind of a more of a bobbiness about it, the way the screen rotates. But this really, really works. I love the turning especially. Whoa, I've just hit his crashed bike. What happened there? I don't know what happened. Oh, whatever it said, I pressed the fire button and missed it. But I seem to have lost the race as a result of hitting his crashed bike. Oh well, result. That was Boss. Cycles, Commodore Amiga. Thanks for watching.